Hello, I'm Bill Morgan, president of Parker University Parker Seminars here in Las Vegas, Nevada, and with me is Heidi Hevick.
Yep.
Thank you for being here. Did I pronounce your name right?
Yes. Well, actually, it's Horvik. It's an old Norwegian name.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah.
So that Norwegian accent I hear, it's...
luckily, it's not a very thick accent because my mother was a Kiwi, so she's a New Zealander, and my dad's Norwegian.
Well, New Zealand accent is really what pops out. And, of course, you've written the book Reality Check, and you've done research, and you're a very popular speaker.
Don't know how that happened.
I know. Well, when we talk, is frequently I cite the same stuff you do.
Yeah.
And people, I think we have a little bit different audience.
I was taking notes during your talk.
Oh, good.
Oh, I wasn't aware of that. I wonder. I'm gonna look that up.
Yeah. Well, good. So, what are you gonna tell us today?
Well, I'm gonna share a lot of the latest research over the last 20 years, showing that chiropractic has a neuroplastic effect on the brain. Because it's so exciting, and it fits with all of the pain literature, all about the neuroplastic effect, especially chronic problems. Try and give a bit of an overview why people get sick to begin with, and then what it is that we chiropractors can do to help.
And I think it's self-evident. I mean, the neuroplasticity thing is just coming, and you know, our founders talked about above down, inside out, but it's probably coming the other way, you know, from below up. Would you agree with that?
They talk about a top-down effect and a bottom-up effect. So I think there's a bit of both, which makes sense, right?
Well, B.J. Palmer was writing about this as I'm reading the green books, kind of looking for pearls from my talks. He has this combination of talking about this lack of connection with the body down below. And I've treated lots of amputees.
That actually makes sense.
Oh, it does.
Yeah.
I go, that goes with what we were talking about with the phantom limb pain.
Yeah.
There's these pearls that these pop out of the green books.
And I think a lot of our symptoms are actually phantom symptoms, just on a milder scale.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah, if you have loose, like we even have people with dorsiflexion problems in their foot, but if you can't dorsiflex, your homunculus is wanting something to happen. It's not happening. You adjust them.
And all of a sudden they can.
You dampen it.
It's that improvement of the communication between the brain, the body, and the environment. And that's what's coming out in all the research that we've been doing as well.
You know, we just started two clinical neuro master's degrees.
I know. I'm so excited.
We're hoping to move those on to a PhD as well, but it's really based on neuroplasticity. Oh, I'm glad to see you excited.
If I can help you, let me know.
Good.
I'd love to.
Good.
Yeah.
And my background is hospital-based chiropractic and seeing blast injuries and what happens when you hit that accidental shear, which happens in soccer injuries, football injuries, car accidents, of course, blast injuries. And I was in the military. I've been around explosions myself. I'm like, oh my gosh, that probably explains a lot.
I won't comment on that
Okay.
I just think of concussions too in sports all the time. Because I think a lot of things are now moving to this brain-based, we're in a brain-based era.
That's
what's so exciting about this research. And, you know, I didn't plan this 20 years ago. Just the data's just taken us in this direction.
Well, as Jim Parker says, it's naturally right. When it becomes naturally right. And plus there's this thing where you and I probably come from different, you know, aspects of chiropractic. It's like, when the truth hits, it transects each other and
it's
self-evident.
Exactly. It's bridging the gap between a lot of what we've seen scientifically and what the clinicians are seeing in practice.
So,
you know, and that's the cool thing too. We can sort of explain now why we can affect just about anything, but we don't fix everything.
Yes.
You know, and that's the key.
Now, in your talks and some of your stuff, you talk about muscle spindle fibers in the small muscles up in the upper cervical.
Yep.
Where I'm mainly a lumbar spine guy.
But they go all the way down.
Oh, I know they do. Yeah. But so I've done more of my research down below.
Yep.
But I know you're working on proprioception up top. And a dear friend of mine, Rob Rosenbaum, the neurosurgeon, just spoke on that junction yesterday. It's great. Yeah.
Oh, I missed that.
Oh, yeah. And the head of our neuro program is, you know, top portion of the cervical spine is where the biggest impact is on that noggin.
Yeah. So. And it is very powerful. It's probably why the whole, hole-in-one upper cervical techniques came from, right?
Yeah, yes.
Because clinically they realize that worked really quite well.
It did.
Yeah.
So,
but we're into full spine too.
Don't
worry.
I started off as an upper cervical.
Did you really?
Yeah. But we'll keep that secret.
Yeah, we will. So, I know. I didn't hear that.
So anyway, thank you so much for coming to Parker. We're so blessed to have you here. Thanks.